Hello friends, and welcome to the unboxing and configuration video of the DSL-2750U N300 ADSL2 Plus router. This router provides transmission speeds of up to 24 Mbps download and 1 Mbps upload. This router comes with 3 years warranty, a 5 dBi long range antenna, and 4000 volts lightning protection. So let's have a look at the back of the box. So here you'll find the information regarding the ports and the ADSL information. So let's have a look at the box contents. So once you open the box, you'll find the router. As you can see, this is a dual antenna router. And at the back of the router, you'll have 4 LAN ports, 1 WAN port, and a power port. You'll also find the quick installation guide and the warranty information. Apart from that, you'll find the DSL cable, the Ethernet cable, the ADSL splitter, and the power adapter. So let's start with the connections. So we start with connecting the power cable to the power port. Then we take the internet service provider cable, which is the RJ11, and we connect it to the WAN port. And then we have to connect the Ethernet cable to any of these LAN ports. I'll connect it in the first. So the other end of this Ethernet cable has to be connected to the Ethernet port of your computer. So let's power on the device. So once you power on the device, you'll see all these LEDs being lit. The first LED is the power LED. The next one is the DSL LED. Right now it's blinking because it is in the process of establishing a connection. So sometimes it takes some time to synchronize. So once it has established a connection, it will stop blinking and it will get connected to the internet. So next LED is the globe LED, which will be lit when you're connected to the internet. So this particular LED indicates that your computer is connected through the first LAN port. And this is the Wi-Fi LED. So let's open up a web browser and enter our router's IP address so that we can set it up. So we go to the address bar and enter 192.168.1.1. That's the router's IP address. So we'll be prompted with this dialog where we have to type the username as well as the password as admin. That's the default setting, and then we click login. Here you'll be directed to the main page of the router's setup, where you can directly follow the setup wizard, or you can go into the internet setup menu and go through the individual setups. The easiest way is to go through the setup wizard. So I will click on setup wizard. So here you'll be briefed through the steps that we'll be going through in this process. You can click next here. So this is the section where you can set up a new password. Your current password is admin, and you can set up any new password of your choice. Confirm the password and click next. Here you can set up your time zone, which is Chennai, Kolkata, Mumbai, and click next. So on this page, you will have to select your country. And after that, you have to select your internet service provider. So once you select your internet service provider, all these details in this section will be automatically configured. The protocol for me is PPPoE since I'm connected to the BSNL network. In the next section, you'll have to enter the username and password provided to you by your internet service provider. If you are not sure about any of these details, you can get in touch with your service provider and get these details. So you confirm your password and click next. So this step lets you configure your wireless network. So you can either enable or disable your wireless network. You can set up a new name for your network, or you can keep the same name. I'll choose to keep the same name. You can also select your visibility status and your security type. I have selected WPA2 since that is supposed to be the strongest type of security. So once you choose the type of security, you'll also get to set your own password. Remember that this is the password that you'll use to connect any of your devices to this particular wireless connection. And click Next. So the next page will show you a summary of all the changes that have been made. You can check all the changes and then click on Apply. And your setup is done. So you can go to the status page and scroll down to check your WAN configuration status. This is where it is. So your wireless protocol is PPPoE and the IP address is a public IP address, which indicates that we are connected to the internet. But just to be sure, let's just try opening up the D-Link website. And yes, the internet is perfectly working. So that is how you configure a DSL-2750U wireless router.